Hi there, welcome to another SkyMind screencast. This is going to be a screencast with a voiceover, and today we're going to cover DataVec image pipeline. Some of the details, we're going to use the parent path label generator to apply labels to a collection of images based upon the directory that they're located in. In addition, we're going to apply an image preprocessing scalar to transform the array of pixel values, which would otherwise be 0 to 255, to a scale between 0 and 1 to make them more appropriate for use in a neural net. And this will be part one of a multi-part series where I'll build upon this code in later examples to build a neural net against this data set, and then train that net, save the network, load the network, and then test it against some unseen images. I will put this code into the examples. We provide a collection of working examples of DataVec and Deeplearning4j, and some of our Spark examples. We try and build examples for most of the functionality in the Deeplearning4j toolkit, and it's available at that URL. Instructions for getting started using the examples are available at the second link. Enjoy! In this example, I'm going to demonstrate using DataVec to parse a directory of images and to prepare that data to be used in a neural net with deep learning for Java. This is going to be part of a multi-series episode where I first show you how to parse the data with DataVec, and then I next show you how to process the data with a neural net, and then I show you how to save that neural net, and then I show you how to test new data, pass new data for inference through to that pre-built and pre-trained neural net. The data I'm going to demonstrate looks like this. It's a directory containing two subdirectories, testing and training, and in each of those there are images in folders 0 through 9. So the name of the folder is the label of the image. The images are 28 by 28 grayscale, the standard MNIST data set. So I'm going to specify that that's our default configuration, 28 by 28 grayscale. If the data is not in that format, the tools available can transform it to that format. To write this example, I'm going to use the examples repo that we make available and we have directions from on our website. I'm going to add it to our DL4J examples. We have some data examples, and I'm going to add it there. There already is an image pipeline example, and this is going to be similar to that. The reason I didn't start with that example, I needed more data than the data that was available in that image pipeline example. So I'm going to create a new class, and I'm going to call this class MNIST image pipeline example. So what we're going to need is I'm going to need a logger. Once I have my logger configured, I'm going to set up my main class. And then here at the top, we're going to need to set some variables. I'm going to set the image information. And what we have is 28 by 28 grayscale. And what the grayscale implies is a single channel. So let's go ahead and configure some variables for that. I'm going to use a random number to randomize the data set, but I want the results to be repeatable. So I'm going to set a seed, and then I'm going to need to generate a random number from that seed. I'm going to set the batch size. I'm going to set it to a very small batch size for the purpose of demonstration only. Right, I want to be able to step through one image at a time and show you the structure. In real life, you'd set a larger batch size. We have 10 different possible values for digits. So I'm going to specify the output num equal to 10. That'll also be the total number of possible labels for our data set. Now let's begin writing some additional code. I'm going to switch to presentation mode, so it'll be easier for everyone to read. And then the next thing we need to add is some file paths. One for our training data, and one for our test data. Let's just put a comment there. In order to process this data, we first begin by specifying a file split. And what we have available to us in file split, we have path, we have allowed formats, so what files within that directory will be parsed. And then because it's so important that the data not come in pre-ordered to the neural net, we can provide a random number to randomize the data. So let's go ahead and define those file splits for each of these. We want a file split, org DataVec split, and we need one for the training data. So we'll call that train, file split, right there. And it's our training data, so we specify the train data from above. We're going to use native image loader, and native image loader gives us allowed formats, and then our random number generator. Okay, so file path, allowed formats from native image loader, and then randomize the data. And we'll do the same for the test data. Now that we've specified the two directories that are going to be read in, and the fact that we're going to randomize the data as we read it in, we then need to specify that we're going to get the labels for the images from the path. And the tool to do that is parent path label generator. We're going to have a label maker. So this specifies that we're going to use the parent path as the label. Next, we specify that we want to read images. So we're going to have an image record reader. And what do we specify when we're reading these images? We specify the height. We specify the width. We specify the number of channels. So using the variables we set above. And then we specify the label maker that we just created the line above. So it specifies that we're going to read this directory. We're going to scale the images to 28 by 28 grayscale, single channel. And we're going to apply the label to the image as it's read as the name of the directory that the image was read from. So what do we have to do next? We're going to need to initialize the record reader. And I'm going to add a listener. Now, in production, you probably wouldn't do this, but I'm going to add a listener to extract the name. And that's just for the purposes of education, to train you on, to show you that this image was read, it had this label, and it looks like this as we pass it as a data set into Deeplearning4j. So first to initialize. And initialize takes a file split. And then let's set that listener. And the listener that I want to specify is a log record listener. So now that we have our record reader and we've attached a listener to that, the next is to set our data set iterator. And the configuration for that looks like this. We specify we want a data set iterator, and I'm going to call it data iter. And we want to use record reader data set iterator. And the idea is we're converting this data we're reading to a collection of records to pass it. So it's kind of like a Hadoop-like analogy in terms of reading an input split, generating a collection of records that we iterate over, a way to pass a collection of values in for processing. So our record reader data set iterator, we pass it our record reader. We specify the batch size, and note that I set the batch size to 1. I'm not recommending you do that in production. I'm doing that for demonstration purposes only. Specify the label and then the output num. So the label index and the number of possible labels. So what we're specifying there is the record reader that we're going to use to iterate across, the batch size, the label index, and the total number of possible labels. That gives us all we need to go ahead and run it. So I'm going to do a little for loop here. Now there's 60,000 images in there. This is just a demonstration. So I just want to loop over 3 of the images. So what the data iterator is going to return as we call next against it, it's going to return a data set. So I'm going to specify my data set called DS equals, and what is a data set? I'm going to display that here in a minute. So what do we have? Data iter next. It's going to return a data set, and I'm just going to print that to the output, right? So for the purpose of demonstration, I'm just going to do system out.println on that data set. In addition to passing the numerical array of the image, the array of possible labels and the label chosen will also be sent. So let's go ahead and print that as well. Okay, and there's that. Let's go ahead and run that code. So when we execute this code, and I'll execute it again to be clear, let's take a look at the output. Two things. What we see right here is the output from that listener I applied on the record reader. So up here I specified record reader set listeners, new log record listener. And what that does is it allows us to see what file's currently being read in. So we see from the directory 2, file 51787 was read. So this should have been labeled as a 2. Next we see the output of the data set. So these are the values for the pixels. So if you were to count across, you'd see 28. If you'd count down, you'd see 28. And the arrangement here of the ones with values, right? So 0 is white. Anything above 0 is some level of gray. There's a very dark pixel there. You can almost see, actually, you know, they're kind of in an example, in a shape like a 2. You can almost see that here. And here we see the labels. So first label, 2. And we see a value of 1 there, so this has been labeled as a 2. So out of the list of possible labels, the first one has a value of 1. So that's our 2. Mostly zeros, white pixels, and then darker pixels. So that's the array of pixels that would be passed into our neural network. And then the next one, we're reading from directory 3. So we should verify that that's been labeled as a 3. And we see there that it has been. And then there we see the array of the pixel values in that 28 by 28 grid for the number 3. Let's add a few more finishing touches to this code. What we see here is an array with mostly zeros, and then the pixels with their brightness, a level from 0 to 255. The issue with this is it might be preferable to have those scaled to a value between 0 and 1. White being 0, pure black being 1. We have the tools available to do that. So let's go ahead and add that to our code. The tool to scale our pixel values between 0 and 1 is a data normalization scaler. So let's scale pixel values to 0 to 1. So we create a data normalization. We're going to call that scaler. And we're going to use image processing scaler and specify 0 to 1. Then we're going to apply scaler to our data iterator. So those three lines define the scaler, call fit, and then apply it to our data iterator. So if I run this now, instead of seeing 21 right here or 82 right there or 253, we'll see values between 0 and 1. So let's go ahead and run that. And there we see it. Right, so when a pixel is dark instead of a number larger than 0 and smaller than 255, we see numbers up to 1. So there's a very dark pixel there, there's a pure light pixel there, and there's some in the middle. There's a nice shade of gray. So at this point, we have the data ready to be passed into a neural net for training, and I'm going to show you how to do that in the next segment. Thank you.